Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Engineering India, give wings to your dreams. My name is Javed and today we are going to discuss about turbocharger. First of all, what is meant by turbocharger? Turbocharger is a mechanical device. It is a forced induction mechanical device which is used to increase the efficiency of an internal combustion engine, that is IC engine, either it may be SI engine or CI engine. This turbocharger was first invented in the year 1896. Later it was used in 1905, and it was invented by a Swiss scientist by name Alfred, and later it was patented. And for its existence, it has taken, after 1905, it has taken almost 20 to 30 years for its existence, because until that people don't know what is the use of turbocharger. I mean, they didn't know that a turbocharger can increase the efficiency of an engine up to 40%. The work of the turbocharger is only just to force the air, I mean the extra amount of air into the engine, and based upon that it increases the efficiency of the engine. Before going into the topic, we need to know a little fundamental about this, that is, based on the classifications of the engine, there is a type that is called based on breathing, based on respiration, or based on breathing. Based on breathing of the engine, there are two types. First one is natural type, second one is forced type. In natural, there will be no extra system, there will be no any blower, there will be no any extra system to force the extra amount of air into the engine. You can observe this in low variant cars, or you can observe this in a two wheeler easily, or you can observe this in a low variant car. There will be an air filter and there will be an hose pipe connected to an inlet system. This is natural type. When suction is created inside the engine, there will be vacuum. To fill that vacuum, air will be drawn into the cylinder. This is a natural type. Whereas in forced induction system, there are two types of chargers. One is turbocharger, another one is supercharger. Turbocharger purely runs on the basis of exhaust smoke or exhaust gas which comes out from exhaust manifold, and supercharger purely runs on the basis of engine power which is transmitted from crankshaft to serpentine belt, and a pulley is connected to that. With the help of that pulley, supercharger will run. Supercharger draws 150 hp power for its working and gives an output of 400 horsepower. Net profit in this is, it gives 250 horsepower net profit. And today we are going to discuss about only turbocharger. First of all, we'll see the parts and we'll know the advantages, the disadvantage, and its working. This is a cut sectional view of a turbocharger. First of all, we'll know the parts of a turbocharger. This is body or casing. This total is body or casing. This is turbine wheel. You can see this one is turbine wheel. And this is shaft connected from turbine wheel to, this one is compressor wheel. This one is compressor wheel. This shaft connects the turbine wheel and compressor wheel. You can see yellow color here. Yellow color is the indication for the passage of oil. Oil is used for lubrication purpose and to reduce the heat. And these are the bearings. And this one is oil ring or O-ring, which is used to block the passage of oil from the system to outside. This one is, this side is called, you can see blue color here. This side is intake side, air intake side. And you can see a hole here. This side is connected to intercooler. This side is connected to intercooler. We are not showing that intercooler, but
You can see the pipe here. From here, this one is inlet, inlet for fresh air, and from here compressed air will go along this pipe to the intercooler. And you can see bottom, you can see my finger there. That side is called this side. This side is called exhaust inlet side. From bottom of this, exhaust gas will come, and from this side exhaust gas will go out. This is called exhaust outlet. This side is called exhaust outlet, which is connected to silencer. From here silencer will come. This side is called exhaust outlet side. This bottom side is called exhaust inlet. This is this side, blue color you can see here. This one is fresh air inlet, and from this pipe compressed air will go out. Now we will know working of this. To the inlet of exhaust side, the exhaust manifold is connected, through which exhaust gas will flow through these pipes. This is all one part, but exhaust smoke or gas will flow through this pipe, and it will flow from here to into these holes. There will be pipe covered, as this is a cut section that is not shown. The exhaust smoke will flow from here to there, to the inside. It will just flow and it will come outside from here. As these, you can see blades are vanes. These blades are designed these are designed with specifications that when air or any gas flows on these and these blades, it automatically starts rotating. The design of the blades is that when air or any liquid fluid passes on these blades starts rotating. It will rotate, and as this is connected to a shaft, it is connected to the compressor wheel. This one is turbine wheel and this is compressor wheel. As the shaft rotates, the compressor wheel also rotates, and the design of these compressor wheel blades is such that as these blades rotate, it draws air from this side, inlet side. There will be pipe connected here. You can see there will be pipe connected here, and then here comes inlet air filter. Through air filter, air filters and comes to here, and these blades sucks the air and compresses the air and transfers the air through this hole to the intercooler. As this turbine wheel rotates, with the help of exhaust gas, when the exhaust gas flows on this turbine wheel, this shaft rotates, and when the shaft rotates, the compressor wheel also rotates. As the compressor wheel rotates, it draws more amount of air into the engine. It draws the more amount of air from outside and compresses with the help of these blades and sends into the engine with the help of this pipe, which is connected to intercooler and then to inlet system. As more air is passed into the engine from this compressor wheel, the combustion will there will be no extra emissions. There will be no wastage of fuel, as there is more amount of oxygen. And the maximum RPM of this turbine wheel is up to 280,000. 280,000 is the maximum RPM in the new turbocharger, whereas in the old ones, the RPM is restricted up to 150,000. This is used in small vehicles where there is no need of very large amount of power. There it is used, and it has advantages and disadvantages. First of all, we will know the advantages. It increases the efficiency of the engine, efficiency of the combustion inside the engine, by pushing the more amount of fuel, more amount of air into the engine. And the disadvantage is that it is, as it is situated in this exhaust system, it has become a hurdle to the exhaust gas. As it comes in between the exhaust pipe, it has become a hurdle to exhaust gas. If there is no turbocharger, the exhaust gas will flow smoothly. As this is a hurdle, it becomes a little difficult for the exhaust gas to flow from here onto the blades, onto this hole, and comes outside to the silencer here. And there is another disadvantage is that that is called turbo lag or spool time. Turbo lag means is that when the engine is at very low speed or at idle condition, the speed of the turbine wheel does not match with the engine speed. As the speed does not match, the turbine gas, the exhaust gas from this hole to this hole will not flow very smoothly. Because it runs with very low speed, the smoke won't flow easily and it won't get outside. Due to that, the pressure will build up here in this system. As the smoke won't flow freely, the pressure will build up in the exhaust system and there is a chance for fire. So this is the disadvantage, that is turbo lag. Turbo lag means that it won't match with the engine speed. As the engine speed increases, then it will match with the engine speed. And if you have any doubts, please comment below. If you like this video, please share and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching this video, friends.